Always a favourite on every rural road. Hyundai Country Calendar.
Holy cow was the idea of using everything from tongue to tail.
They're growing local food for local people.
This farm can sustain our community. We don't need to kind of take on the world.
And the whole family is involved.
When he first walked into the store, he wouldn't even go out and talk to the customers or nothing. Now, you can't get him away from them.
In the rolling hills south of Cambridge, this 200 hectare farm has been home to the Andrews family for 13 years. Tom Andrews does much of the hands-on farm work himself.
Wait, it is just pretty well me on the farm. The stock work in there, it's just me because my dogs only really listen to me. Get away, big. They won't listen to anyone else, unfortunately. I've just made it so it's real simple in the way that we've got a central laneway running right through the whole property and then everything runs off that, so it's quick, safe and easy.
This morning, Tom's putting this mob of cattle through the yards for weighing.
Push up. Turn around.
Let's do it. It's running through them and just looking at the weight, but then actually looking at the condition of them as well. So that one there's just under 500 kilos, but it's still growing up, so. So we'll let that one run. Now this one here looks like he's got a bit more condition straight away. I'd say he's in and he's just over 500. So we'll put that one out over there and then go and get some more. Easy as that.
These animals are destined for the Andrews' own butcher's shop in Cambridge, run by Tom's son, Luke.
Good girl. Yeah, overall not too bad. A little bit light, eh? A little bit lighter than I would like at the moment. But I suppose you always like a little bit more on them. That one there's quite good, but just too small still at the moment. Luke likes them like that in the shop, nice and small. Yeah, just easy to bone out, quick and easy, rather than a big muscle form on them, eh? So it's all good. It's all good. He gets what I give him.
In nearby Cambridge, Tom's wife, Carrie, is behind the counter today at Holy Cow.
Look, kind of a little bit shy today.
Yeah.
Woo-hoo. Here you go. Here.
Thank you.
See you later. Bye-bye. This has been an existing butcher for over 100 years. So we took over 5 years ago. For us, the focus would be to align the traditional but with a modern appeal. People want convenience, but they also would like to be environmentally friendly. We used to use the traditional plastic butcher's bags, and now we know that plastic's not everyone's friend. I came up with this one. And this is from tallow, which is the fat that I render down from the beef that we take off the farm. And that is worked a treat. It's quite a simple idea, but it replaces now probably up to 800 bags a week that we go through. And that's an easy solution. But to me, that's a win. For us to be about sustainability, we can only do so much. We don't want to be intensive on the farm, so therefore we need to just keep it local. I'll give you a bit of rosemary for your lamb. And there's enough people here to make the business grow. Little systems like this could replicate in different parts of the country for their communities. Doesn't make sense to us to be sending our meat elsewhere because other people in that area could do the same. Just let me know, Doe, if there's something you need, can't find it, you know the drill.
Carrie and Tom's 19-year-old son Luke has gradually grown his responsibilities at the shop and now runs the business day to day.
When Luke was 10 years old, he decided he'd like to go out with the home kill trucks, and so he started on the holidays, go out with the next door neighbour who's a butcher, and they'd start teaching him a few tricks of the trade. So Luke came out of school earlier and got his apprenticeship and fully qualified by 18. The beauty of having your own family business is that he's been exposed to a lot more than, say, the average, so his skill set's really big for a young guy.
Normally on Monday we're breaking all the beef down, dicing it all up, getting it ready for the week ahead. I've had good people to train me up. We all work as a team down here. Everyone's highly qualified and know what they're doing. So it makes my life a lot easier knowing there's other people that can do everything. And I'm always learning from them too.
Back at the farm, Tom's bringing in some lambs destined for the abattoir later this week.
Come up, keep it up.
Keep out. Keep out. We're just going to go through and draft a few out. So these are all ready to go down to the shop. We're going to do 25 tomorrow. These are late lambs from last year. They're all getting quite sizable, although I quite like them like that because they're a little bit more flavour to them than that. Man, we get a lot of people asking for hoggets, so we do have a few of them running through as well. And we go for a good solid Romney with a Suffolk cross. They tend to get a little bit longer, and you might get an extra couple of loin chops out of it, so it's sort of like another couple of bucks, you know.
Previously, when their livestock was going to be processed at the works, the animals faced hours on the road in a truck. But now, the Andrews have their own on-farm abattoir.
This is our little micro-abattoir that we've built ourselves here. We built it about two and a half years ago now. It took us about another 2 years to get through all the paperwork and R&Ps and everything else. We can do our own animals on-farm. I mean, they're all registered and everything, it's all MPI'd, so it's all fantastic. We've got our own independence with it, right through from the paddock to the butchery. We can just do what we want when we want in the animal line. So at the present, we just do one day a week, and that's enough for us to keep going and just keep topping up our chiller and all that.
Every week, they process around 5 cattle beasts and 25 sheep.
What we found is there's just no stress in the animals. They're coming straight from the paddock just into a little set of yards that they're used to going into out the back here, and then we just bring them in and carry on our job from there. And it's no trucking or anything like that of animals, so we don't have to move animals up and down the country. It's all just straight from here, straight down to the shop. It's fantastic. We got Luke, my son, he's over there, and Dallas, he's our new apprentice. We're trying to teach him something. He's coming along all right. He's getting into it. And Jace, he helps with a lot of the maintenance and building of things, and we're always altering things around and changing things. And Chris, our inspector, he's here as well.
Local vet Chris Cricket inspects the carcasses to ensure everything is up to scratch. The meat is left hanging in the chiller till it's time to truck it to the shop. Carrie likes their new way of working.
When we originally started, it was quite easy in the sense you farmed it, you put it on a truck and off it went. No connection, whereas now it's not only a financial gain, like we have a connection to our community with the people. It seems to me more of a holistic approach because there's many more avenues rather than just getting finances return. You're getting more of a well-being return because you have a relationship with the customers, you have the families involved. It feels for well-being, it feels much more complete.
And to drive from one part of their business to the other takes only 20 minutes. At the Holy Cow Butcher in Cambridge, 19-year-old Luke Andrews and 17-year-old apprentice Dallas Prince are making sausages.
Yeah, when Dallas first started, he never could keep up. He'd always get way behind. We'd have to give him a hand, getting him ahead. And now he can't keep up with enough sausages on the table for him.
You'd have piles up to here when I first started. Now, got the hang of it, eh? Every single week, sausage, sausage, sausage.
Dallas has really stepped up and become, yeah, top sausage person, really, now. He controls it.
Big boss dog of this whole thing.
Yeah, he's going really well, though, for apprentice.
The arms get a bit of a workout after you've done 20 buckets of it.
Good for you.
Yeah.
Hand-linking sausages is a nod to the traditional butchery trade. But Holy Cow is also embracing the latest technology as well.
Oh, look at that, pork sausages.
We've brought out a new meat app, which you can download on your smartphone, and you can choose anything you want. As you don't just have to choose meat box kind of thing. You can customise your order to whatever you want. And it gets delivered to you Tuesday to Friday morning throughout Cambridge and Hamilton. Good morning.
Luke, how are you?
Here's some of your lovely eye fillet steaks you ordered.
That looks beautiful.
Awesome,
thank you,
mate.
So much.
No worries. Have a good day. I'll see you around.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Luke's mum and dad, Carrie and Tom, are proud of how far he's come.
Luke's always been really, really interested in it. Back in the earlier days, we were doing just our stuff for ourselves. He'd always be there helping out as well. So he's sort of gone along and followed straight into the butchery side of things, and he's pretty well doing all the running of the store now. So it's fantastic he's taken that load off us. And he's really grown with confidence with it too. When he first walked into the store and started cutting a bit of meat, he wouldn't even go out and talk to the customers or nothing. Now, geez, you can't get him away from them.
I wake up every morning, go to my job, and just awesome. We have a real good time in the butcher shop. We're one big team. Like, it's a big family kind of thing in the butcher shops. Everyone's so happy to be at work. Doing the deliveries is great, eh? They get out of the shop and actually meet the customers. I can see the whole side of the business. It makes me feel good about myself, selling them good product. It's a small community too, Cambridge is. So everyone sort of knows everyone, and which makes it just awesome. You know, word of mouth around town is amazing for the shop.
Carrie and Tom's daughter, Grace, has inherited her parents' philosophy on sustainability. She runs a consignment clothing store across the road from the butchery.
Hiya. To me, sustainability is the only way that we can go in the future. Why buy something new when there is so much and so much good things that are already made? There's no point of saying, hey, let's not shop, let's not do any of that, because people aren't going to follow it. Let's do it a different way and make it, you know, better for the environment and a little bit more eco-friendly. Everything in the store, all the clothing is all secondhand. All of the decorations and everything is either upcycled or secondhand. We don't buy barely anything new. All the tags and everything's all recycled. All of the business cards are made with like recycled card. All of the clothes that we do not accept is all donated. It's all just continuously going around. There's not a lot of waste.
It's all the more impressive when you learn Grace is just 17 years old.
Grace is pretty assured of herself and always has been. She came out of school at 14.
Her choice?
Her choice, because she felt it was irrelevant. And we have always kind of said to the children, life is about choices, and so everyone has a choice to do something. And really what we gave her the opportunity to do was learn about who she was and what she wanted, because it is her life, and she's going to curate it as she chooses.
I love the constant interaction with people and the constant kind of joy that it brings in. And so it's great to see when you put yourself out there with an idea and it's like, you have no idea if it's going to work, and it does.
Awesome, thank you. Is that the jacket you bought here?
Yes.
I love it.
Awesome. The family strives to use as much of the animal as they can. Back home at the farm, one of Carrie's creative solutions is making beauty products from the waste beef fat.
This is the tallow skin lotion, which is amazing for one's skin, any part of the body actually, because it's only three ingredients. So you've got your tallow, which I rendered down twice, and then you, of course, naturally you purify it and filter it, so you're not going to smell like a beefcake. And then olive oil and essential oil. And so this one is orange, because who doesn't like a little bit of citrus? And then whip it up, pipe it in, and away we go. For me, that's the enjoyable part. You can use all the parts of the animal, and it actually feeds your skin rather than just sort of sitting on top and disappearing. A lot of customers now are finding it's working for them.
And their waste products feed not just their customers' skins, but the soil on their farm as well.
Oh, how exciting. Everyone should have a worm farm.
Cambridge is well known for its horse stables. And sheep and beef farmers Tom and Kerry Andrews have found a way to reuse the large amounts of manure that the local horses create.
We've got all the horse manure and straw and stuff that comes from the racing stables and that down Cambridge. And we truck it up every couple of months. We go around, I go and check them all out, and spend a couple of days carting into here when the weather's good. And then we pour our leftovers from the plant into it. And then leave it sit for a while, and we turn it and sit it and turn it and sit it. And then in about a year's time, it's all composted down and ready to put out onto the farm. And hopefully that'll take place for our nutrients and fertiliser and stuff like that in time to come. So it's all new. We're just working our way through it. Everything's in a big cycle. The stuff that we've put in here has actually come from the farm, so we're actually going to be putting it back onto the farm.
And in a nearby paddock, Tom's wife Carrie is tending some of the farm's smallest livestock.
These are the worm beds, which have slowly grown from originally just a metre with 5 kg of worms, and since then we've just slowly each week we add on segments and the worms multiply constantly. We're now ending up with 6 beds. And what they're doing for us is they're taking all the paunch, which is the undigested grass from the beef, and then we bring it over here. And now we've got a way of converting all our waste meat trays that people bring back, and paper towels and all our cardboard we can combine with the paunch, which turns it into vermicompost and then spread it on the farm. Our son Reuben came up with the name Holy Cow at 10, and now at 13 years later it seems really fitting, because Holy Cow was the idea of using everything from tongue to tail, and the whole animal was used, and now it's kind of still that philosophy where we're looking at the whole cycle of the food journey from the farm back to the plate, and now we're trying to bring it all back to the farm. I've just learnt by doing it, and I really enjoy that aspect of this, because everything else in the abattoir and with the health and safety is we are so managed and everything, whereas I love coming to the worms where you can just sort of experiment without too many regulations. Oh, look at that. See that? Oh, look at that. I still get like, oh, how exciting when I find these little clumps of worms. Everyone should have a worm farm, because they just convert waste and make a valuable product. Hey, Hazel.
When the work is done for the day, home-cooked meals always draw the family close.
Bit of lamb, butterfly lamb, leg. Yeah, love it. Love it, yeah, that's good. And it's easy to carve like that too. Get rid of the bone and it's just straight into it.
Yeah, the tower's real nice.
Luke
here,
and Grace still live at home, but Tom and Carrie's older two kids have moved away.
How was everything?
21-year-old Reuben works in Hamilton, but he stops by when he's finished to catch up with the whānau. The couple's eldest, 24-year-old Olivia, is living in Denmark.
Olivia May, she is a graphic designer, so she does all the graphics for the business, and we miss her a lot. And that's the thing about a family farm. I remember, as being the youngest, that there was always points in time where a sibling ended up back at home. There's something really solid rock about having a piece of land that, you know, with COVID and everything, you've got a land to sort of grow your own food, get your water, and this way we can kind of safeguard our future and our children's future by keeping it small and circular, really. We never set out to do any of this, but for us, that you see opportunities and you take them, and also we like being in control of our own destinies. And who knows what we might be doing next. That's how we roll.
Who knows what's going to come along.
Calves are just about to start, so keep them done.
Are you going to go away? Yeah. We keep them for Christmas.
Calendar was brought to you by Hyundai New Zealand.